Twins and the Sun.
The Roseworth Railway has many important places that feed our home economy. There's the Lower Fairview Harbour that stores containers and other important cargo that comes in from the ships. There are the passenger services that carry passengers from Lower Fairview Holt to Barrow in Furness on the mainline, with minor stops like Sheriff Sutton and Red Code. Then there's the quarry. The quarry is important as it is full of stones and sand for building things. The quarry is at the helm of three locomotives, the Twins Colonel and General, who shunt in and out of the quarry, while Franklin pulls loaded trucks either to the harbour or to the Fairview Terminal shunting yards when any of us are not available. One particular afternoon, Franklin was heading to Fairview Terminal shunting yard with a heavy load of stone that was bound for the mainline. As he was puffing along the line, he began to hear a distinct creaking noise in his cylinder.
Driver, I hear something going on with my pistons. Can we check it out when we get to as soon as possible?
Sure. I don't think we can stop here though, but I can check when we get to Fairview Terminal shunting yards.
But when Franklin got to the shunting yards, there was a big loud bang. Everyone stopped to see if Franklin was alright, and thankfully he was, but his left cylinder wasn't. It turned out that his left cylinder had a pin loose inside and needed to be replaced. Claudette shunted Franklin to the works for a new pin, but only to find out that they had no pin for Franklin. The yard manager, who heard about Franklin, came in.
Where are we going to get an engine at this point now? I might know a friend who could help, sir. He comes from the Solar System Railway, and he did visit your railway before. Okay, I'll make the arrangements with his manager at once. Ah, new poodle can't do anything without me. I'll be glad to work at the quarry for him.
Okay, hold up now. You hate pulling trucks here on the Solar System Railway. But when you're out on other people's railways, you're happy to do it.
Don't you worry about that now, Jupiter. Anyways, I will go and get a support coach and I will be on my way.
Oh yes!
For heaven's sake!
Oh no, he's back!
Oh, good, Resley. Sunstar arrived at the works to see Franklin idling and waiting for his parts to arrive.
Well, well, well. I knew you would arrive on time. Well, you know me. The famous Sunstar Limited is never late. Anyways, what should I be doing for my duration of my time here, Pluto? It's Franklin, and you'll be hauling stone from the yard to the docks. Got it. Oh, and watch out for the Twins, Colonel and General, my colleagues. They don't take kindly to new replacements. Ha! I think I can handle those two twins.
But that was easier said than done. When Sunstar got to the quarry, he got a nasty surprise. A bunch of trucks were blocking his path to get in.
Now who put these trucks here?
Sunstar looked around to see two black tender engines staring at him.
Who are you?
Yeah.
Well, my name is Sunstar. I am known for pulling the iconic Sun...
No one cares what you pull, Mr. Star Sun. You have no right to go poking around Franklin's work.
Oh, I'm not here poking around Franklin's work. I'm here to replace him.
Sunstar should have used a better word as it made the twins seethe with anger. But the twins knew they didn't have time to argue and pushed the trucks aside. But they weren't going to let Sunstar off the hook that easily. They tried all sorts of mean tricks in hopes of getting Sunstar to leave, like putting diesel oil in the water, putting stones in the coal hopper, and giving him the wrong trucks to take. All in all, the big green DB10 steam engine was getting upset. That night, Sunstar decided to stay at Fairview Shed and asked some of us how to deal with Colonel and General's tricks.
Do any of you know how to deal with Colonel and General's tricks?
The quarry twins? Why?
They've been tricking me non-stop all day, and I'm tired of it.
Well, you can always try talking to them and telling them to stop.
And getting yourself tricked even more, I don't think so. This is what you should do, Sunstar.
When Duchess of Sutherland finished telling Sunstar her plan, Sunstar was pleased. So early that morning, Sunstar put her plan into motion. The twins shunted Sunstar's train to the back of him. When the guard climbed into the brake van and blew his whistle, Sunstar raced off like the wind, dragging the twins behind him before they were uncoupled from the train. The twins became frantic and begged Sunstar to stop.
Please, Mr. Sun, stop!
Wait, Colonel. Where is this train heading to?
I think the shunting yard! Wait! I remember now! This train is bound for the Carnival Railway! Great!
And indeed the twins were right. Sunstar booked it down the line and arrived at Carnival Railway. By the time the train arrived at the Carnival Railway, the twins and the trucks were relieved and frightened.
This will teach you mangy old clowns not to mess with the iconic Sunstar!
Just then, the yard manager and the quarry manager both arrived on board Franklin.
What do you think you're playing at, dragging the twins along the main line? I'm sorry, sir, but these twins need a lesson that they need to be taught. That's no excuse for dragging them along the line. Nor for you two to be mean. Sunstar was here to help us, while Franklin was at the works.
Sorry, Mom.
Well, now that we got that sorted out, Sunstar, as you can see, Franklin's back with us, meaning that you'll have to go back to your railway. We'd like to thank you on behalf of the Roseworth Railway for coming to help us. I understand, sir.
Later that night, Franklin arrived to say goodbye to Sunstar.
I must admit, it was fun coming back to this railway. It was fun having you here. Oh, I also wanted to say that the twins apologized for their trickery. Oh, well, tell them I forgive them. Okay, Sunstar. Will do. Have a good trip. Safe travels.
Wait! Mr. Sunstar, we never got a chance to talk!
And that, my friends, was that.
Well, well, well. I got a chance to talk to your idol, O'North?
Zip it, Gadwall!
What, aren't you upset that your iconic Sunstar Limited is gone?
That's enough for you two. Besides, we have bigger problems here.
What's the news that you heard?
Unfortunately, that old logging station next to Shedfield is gonna be turned into an airport.
Oh, no.
Hey, is that Ivers?
Should we tell him the news? I'd rather not.
Looks like he's gotten into an accident. Again.
This is getting ridiculous. It's the fourth accident he's had this month.
Oh, bother, Heechan. This is getting way too old.
What's that curse slash mystery slash... you know what I mean.
He has... Beats me.
I might know a friend who could help us. Croven, meet me at Vickerstown Bridge tomorrow night.
Okay.